Welcome to our Christmas Eve service. We appreciate you tuning in. This has been a program put together by the Hartsonger Choir, directed by Dalton Fitzgerald and assisted by Judy Preble. And we have our wonderful sound team that has been working tirelessly to make this production for you be heartfelt and uplifting. That is Melinda Miller-Castro, Dave Arnold, and Stephen Smith. And so we appreciate all of the many wonderful hearts that put this together. So I'm going to begin with an opening blessing to bless our day, this special Eve. So join with me as we celebrate the holidays, each one a witness to the divine love that is ever pouring through each and every one of us. I give thanks for the opportunity to have ritual, to have light, to have love, come together on the eve of a very special day, and to allow each and every one of us to open our hearts, to sit in a space of calm and recognize we are all one, and there are many blessings that we are grateful for. So I release this prayer knowing that we are held in that light and that love, and together we say, and so it is.
Hi guys, it's Holly Day from home. Wishing everybody a Merry Christmas. Wish we could be together, but we will be soon. I promise. So have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide together. If the faith so long. So hang a shining star upon the highest bough, and have yourself a merry little Christmas now. Happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends who are dear to us, gather near to us once more. Through the years, we all will be together. If the fates allow, so hang that shining star upon the highest bough, and have yourself a merry little Christmas. Have yourself a blessed little Christmas. Have yourself a merry little Christmas now. Merry Christmas.
Tannenbaum, oh Tannenbaum, wie treu sind deine Blätter. Oh Tannenbaum, wie treu sind deine Blätter. Du bringst nicht nur zur Sommerzeit, nein, auch im Winter, wenn es schneit. Oh Tannenbaum, wie treu sind deine Blätter. Oh Christmas tree, how lovely are thy branches. Oh Christmas tree, how lovely are thy branches. Not only green when summer's here, but in the coldest time of year. Oh Christmas tree, how lovely are thy branches. Oh Christmas tree, thy candles shine so brightly. Oh Christmas tree, thy candles shine so brightly. Each bough doth hold its tiny light, which burns unchanging through the night. Oh Christmas tree, thy candles shine so brightly.
So I am going to share a few words with you. My part of this message has to do with celebrating the dark. So I start with a quote from Paramahansa Yogananda. He says this: life has a bright side and a dark side, for the world of relativity is composed of light and shadows. If you permit your thoughts to dwell on evil, you yourself will become ugly. Look only for the good in everything, so that you absorb the quality of that beauty. Does that sound familiar? Ernest Holmes reminds us as well that to continue to always look for the good. So this has been a year of reflection. And part of these holy days that we celebrate now, part of this is the solstice, which we honor the dark and the light. We're also honoring the tradition of Christmas and Hanukkah and Kwanzaa. But I'm speaking to this idea of the season of darkness. So as the natural time, at this time of year, the days become shorter and the nights become longer. It's a natural time for each of us to process the events of the year, especially our soul growth. I read an article that emphasized how important it is to look inside. It is why, I quote, we need to revive and maintain a tradition of hibernating and reclaiming our animistic legacy of connection to season, taking the winter season to reconcile our soul work of the year is living the metaphor of finding the light within. So we are invited to tend to the darkness. There is something welcoming or alluring to me in particular about a gray, rainy day. It invites us to have the opportunity to slip into a space where we can be quiet. We can pay attention to what might be brewing in our deepest thoughts. Darkness can be a safe place for this contemplation to gently allow us to awaken and lead us into a revelation of greater understanding. And what a greater time than this time of year, having experienced COVID experiences and different moments of unsettled experiences out in our world with our neighbors and friends, and we come to a time of generosity and kindness, and we invite ourselves to open our hearts to that and allow our understanding to awaken on such a deep level. This article on Spirituality and Health by Barbara Mahoney, she speaks directly to this. Have we blinded ourselves to the darkness? Have we cut ourselves off from the God-given ebb and flow of darkness and light? Are we lost? She states the truth is, darkness draws us out from our deep down depths. Darkness is a womb. It is the seed underground. Darkness is where birthing begins, the incubator of unseen stirring, essential and fundamental for growth. So think about this evening as being a time of anticipation, waiting for something, almost holding your breath, wanting that light from within to shed an understanding, something inward stirring inside of you, whispering to you, please come closer. Discover this abundance within. Marvel at the gifts the One has bestowed upon each and every one. So the questions that you need to answer, perhaps. Are you living the life that you want? Are you loving your life? What have your fears this year led you to understand? And what needs your attention now? What do you need to let go of and not carry into the next season? These are the holy days, calling you to shine, to discover the radiance of truth by delving deep into your heart of darkness. It's where your prayer begins. Be still. Find some of those moments over the next few days of stillness and close your eyes so gently. Lean into those whispers of your heart. And as you open your eyes, witness the twinkling of lights all around you that are on display to remind you. So within, so without. And close your eyes again and allow that darkness to bring you comfort now as you begin to discover the true light, the light of that divine intelligence that connects us to our senses, to our oneness. As Rainier Maria Rilke says in her poetry, I love the dark hours of my being, for they deepen my senses. From them, I've come to know that I have room for a second life, timeless and wide. So I invite you to discover what's inside of you as you spend a few moments in that sacred stillness in these holy days. To now invite Dr. Mary to come forward, and she's going to share about the light. Dr. Mary.
Thank you, Sue. Good evening, everyone. You know, a few years ago, I heard an author on the radio who was being interviewed about what he wrote about World War I, A Christmas Truce. Have you ever heard about this, Sue? World War I? It's an amazing story. No one's really certain how it began, but it was December 24th, 1914. It was a day like every other miserable winter day in Europe. The British, the French, the Belgium, and the German troops were all only 60 yards apart in their own trenches, so close that they could see and hear each other. Conditions were bad. Cold rain flooded the trenches. There were rats and mud and filth. It was impossible to lie down, so the soldiers had to sleep standing up. So here they were on Christmas Eve. In that atmosphere of war and suffering, the soldiers felt a real need for rest, a time of peace, Christmas Eve. Many noticed that the Germans in their trenches had been receiving Christmas trees from their supporters at home, and they were lining their trenches with these trees and then clamping candles to them like they always did in tradition when they were home. And the British thought that maybe this was a declaration, a Christmas declaration. So they began launching pudding and chocolates and all kinds of things at the Germans. And all of a sudden, Christmas carols began to be sung in that cold night air. And the soldiers on both sides realized, you know, we know that song too. And so they all started singing together. No one's really sure who crawled out of their trench first, but eventually all sides came out and they met in the space they called No Man's Land. They decided to call a timeout so they could all retrieve the bodies of their fallen comrades. And when that was done, the enemies returned to No Man's Land. And they decided to play soccer. For two whole days, they played soccer in No Man's Land. And between all the fraternizing they were doing with each other, at the risk of being court-martialed, of course, It was there at that place and time that the soldiers realized that on each side of the war, they were the same. And a power of peace came upon them. They exchanged addresses and expressed admiration for each other. But then some angry officers came and said, "Get back into that trench and start shooting again." But they couldn't. They couldn't because they aimed, and so they aimed their guns high in the air and shot in the air. You know, it kind of reminds me of what we've been going through all year, politically divided in this country, hate spewed from so many sources, anger surfaced in so many ways, finger pointing on both sides. And when we recognize our humanity, our oneness, we find a place where we can at least respect one another. And then a light begins to shine. So as we light candles tonight in your home and here, let the warmth of that glow penetrate your heart and know that every person you meet has a face, a family, and a story.
God rest ye, merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day to save us from our darkest hour when we were gone astray. Tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Ooh, tidings of comfort and joy. In Bethlehem in Israel, a blessed babe was born. His mother Mary did nothing take in scorn. Ooh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Ooh, tidings of comfort and joy. From God our Heavenly Father, blessed angel came, and unto certain shepherds brought tidings of the same. How that in Bethlehem was born the Son of God by name. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Comfort and joy. Now to the Lord sing praises, all within this place, and with true love and brotherhood, each other now. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort.
Now, I'm going to invite all of you to look around your home right now and find a candle that you can bring forward to an imaginary altar before you. And as you find that candle, maybe it's one that was a gift to you and you keep saving it year after year because it's so beautiful. Tonight is the night to light that candle, to light that gift, and to remember that there'll be many more lights and candles in your journey. So light this one that is special to you this evening. So take a few moments in preparation for that. And then as Dr. Mary and I work through this moment together ourselves, as we recognize what a year it's been for us, what a challenging year it's been for us at times, the COVID, the closing down of the center, the speaking into an empty room, yet knowing that out there, our heart's listening, and we carry on. So I have great admiration for the staff, and for Mary, and for myself, and for the team that shows up on Sundays, the skeleton crew that says, we'll do this, we can do this together. I light my candle in the honor of all the hearts that allowed this year to be brought forth in such beauty. So I hope you have your candle right now. And I'm going to have Mary light her candle and hold it in front of her with her hand on her heart as well. And hear these words with me. As I light this candle, I call upon the Spirit of Peace. You who have been portrayed as a gentle dove and a serene goddess, and in many other beautiful and noble forms, I call upon you. I ask you to reside with me and bless me with all the ways of peace. Peace be in me. Peace be with me. Peace be all about me. Peace, let it flow inward and outward, and let the Spirit of Peace bring harmony to all those around me, and extend forever onward to transform this world with the great loving presence. Let all people's minds and hearts be filled with the love of peace. Let all people's actions be fixed on the works of peace. Thus will harmony renew the earth and gladden the heart of the great world soul herself. The seasons have made their circles, and I light this candle to celebrate the sun's renewal. As people everywhere, as you join us in illuminating your candle, we are illuminating these long midwinter nights. So may we each find comfort and hope in the ever-returning light. Light the candles and we give thanks for all the good things that we enjoy. Peace, prosperity, the love of friends and family, and so much more. Let us ever be mindful of the blessings that are here for us this moment, hour by hour, day by day. So it is, and so it shall be. I now light my candle. And we, Mary, come stand next to me. We are here for you. We are in service to you. And when you don't know where your own light is, we continue to see the light within you. And we hold that dearly. We hold that charge as one of the greatest opportunities we've ever been given as ministers for this center. So blessings upon you, and may you enjoy all of these holy days, however they are celebrated in your tradition. Namaste. Tender and mild.
sleep in heavenly peace. Sleep in heavenly peace. So
as we close this evening's special experience, we do feel the divine presence all around us. And as we commune with this divine omnipresence, we know it's the power to overcome darkness, no matter where we are. Not by combating it, but being exactly what it is, the light. We're so grateful to all those in the medical community who care for so many during this virus. We are so grateful to the people all over the world working hard for a vaccine, because their work will culminate in thousands of people continuing to live a prosperous life. You know, yes, it's been a challenging year, but tonight we celebrate all the goodness that's come along with that. Somewhere this year, good has come your way. Maybe in a form of a person, a gift, a smile, a thank you, but there's goodness out there because it's in our hearts. The goodness is in our hearts. So in this atmosphere, we humbly invite you to share that goodness with each other as a reminder of God's love for each one of us. Share it. Feel the goodness. Feel the grace. Merry Christmas. And so it is.